to kill him? Do you want to kill him? It's only we are sucking on. That was the exact words I used on my elder son. The day he was angry, came back from school. I don't know what his younger brother did to him. And Baskops, he was just like, rah, rah, rah. And I just like, I saw the younger brother come and say, what is it? I just had to ask him, do you want to kill him so that only you will stay? All right. But God taught me a lesson. And I want to share that lesson with every parent here. Our sons must be brothers. Did you hear what I said? Our sons must be brothers. Come, let me share with you what I got. And let me share it with you. Genesis chapter 4 verse 9. Then the Lord said to Cain, where is your brother Abel? I don't know, he replied. Am I supposed to look after my brother? Cain replied to God, am I supposed to look after my brother Abel? Remember, he had already killed his brother because there was this anger, this jealousy because God accepted his Abel's own sacrifice and God did not accept Cain's own. What am I saying? Dear parents, are we just going to raise sons or are we going to raise brothers? Like brothers, close brothers, brothers that respect themselves, brothers that look out for themselves. When I read this Genesis chapter 4, I had to drop my notes. When I started dropping my notes, the only thing that kept coming to my mind was, Lord, my sons will be brothers. Lord, my sons will be brothers. Why was God putting that word or that prayer in my mind? As of then, I didn't know. But gradually, it began to dawn on me that parents, we don't just have to raise sons. We have to raise brothers. Why am I saying this? There's a difference between raising sons and having sons who you raised become brothers. Yes, brothers who care for themselves, brothers who bless themselves, brothers who love themselves, brothers who have each other's back. But let me tell you, one of the major reasons, I don't know if Adam and Eve contributed to whatever happened between Abel and Cain, but I am talking to you today. Yes, you, and myself today, we are going to be the reason, some of us are going to be the reason our sons never became brothers. Some of us parents, our attitude, our words, our comparison, our love that is seen to the other brothers we have for one is going to be the reason some of our sons are going to have, like, become enemies on each other. You don't say, look at your younger brother. If Rocco Seme, you are always lazy. Look at your younger brother doing so well. Or in return, you're saying to the younger one, look at your elder brother. You can't copy his good character. You can't do this. Please stop comparing. You are building jealousy. Stop comparing. You are building jealousy. Please, let us grow each other's strength. Let us encourage each of our sons to come out of their weakness. Let's embrace their strength. Let us not, for any reason, begin to compare the strength of one son to that of the younger one, or the strength of the middle son to that of the elder son. Please, it is not needed. If you want to raise brothers, unless you want to raise sons, you can continue comparing. Please do not build hatred between your sons or amongst your sons because you want to love the younger one more than the elder one. You see, some families, maybe the younger one made money more than the elder one. You see parents beginning to love the younger one more. Or that the elder one is doing well, then the younger one is still struggling, or the middle son is still striving to come out, and you begin to, you know, like the one that is doing good, or the one that is more intelligent, or the one that listens to you. Why don't you come down to the level of the other one and find out his area of strength, or find out why these things happen? You'll be able to hear a lot that you have done if truly parents want to embrace the real truth. We will hear what we might have done that we didn't even take notice of that is hurting a particular child of ours. Now, what I now did after I read this particular passage of the Bible, something occurred, and I started it this year with my sons. I told my son, every morning before both of you leave for school, you will do what? You will bless yourselves. What am I saying? You are going to speak good things in your life I bless my brother, or I bless you today with the love of God. I bless you today with the peace of the Lord. When my elder son does that to the younger one, the younger one in return does it to the elder one. What am I trying to do? I'm trying to build an environment where I raise brothers that will bless themselves. I raise brothers that will take care of themselves. I raise sons that if this one is stranded, he will not just call his brother because he needs money, but he can call his brother because he needs spiritual support, he needs physical support, he needs, you know, you call your brother because you need the strength that you cannot give yourself. Now, when you look at who were other brothers again in the Bible, Jacob and Esau, we wouldn't want to raise our sons to be like that, like having this envious kind of spirit around themselves, having reasons to quarrel or have some kind of aggression or this kind of bitterness amongst themselves. What am I even saying? What of the children of Jacob themselves? You saw what happened in Joseph's life. Who wants such? Joseph was his brother's brother, but his brothers were not their brother's brother. I don't know if you got what I said. He was happy to have brothers, but were his brothers happy to have him? Because there was this one-sided love from their father. It's not like their father woke up and said, look, I'm going to love this particular son. But maybe because of Joseph's obedient life and all of that, it was so sweet to him and all of that, forgetting that the other ones were not feeling so happy with it. So when I finished reading this Genesis, it dawned on me that the way I shouted at my first son was very, very wrong. Yes, he was wrong for being like pouring his anger on his brother. But did he actually want to do that? I would have called him to find out. You don't behave like this to your brother because I know that you protect him, you care for him. How come you reacted this way? I didn't even find out what happened to him in school. And I started like, do you want to kill him? Come on. Would he want to kill his brother? So, parents, fathers, mothers, please, there should be no one-sided love. There should be no one-sided praise. Ah, this is my son. And in front of that one, you are trying. Oh, call me. This son. Oh, mommy, dada. Excuse me. The other ones, did you pick them from the gutter? So please, I am begging. Like, let us not make these mistakes unknown to us. These are silent things that the other children will be observing. They might not speak about it, but gradually when they grow. Funny enough, when we are praying, Lord, I pray that my children will love themselves. I pray that my sons will love themselves. I pray that my daughters will love themselves. Meanwhile, you are building, you are planting, you are there watering hatred amongst your children, unknown to you. So parents, please, why should we not just have sons, but raise brothers? Let me tell you. Brothers, when we raise brothers, shift from the mindset of saying, I have sons too, I am raising brothers. When we raise brothers, we raise a nation. Like different nations that will stand in unity to help each other. When we raise brothers, we are raising solution providers. We are raising worthy communicators. We are raising great fathers. We are passing on legacy, like passing the torch of leadership. We are passing love. We are raising people who will be compassionate. We are raising men who will be empathic. We are raising brothers who will build family. We are raising people that will say, indeed, we have come to be shown a way that we are not just sons, but we are brothers. We are raising people who will tie themselves in unity. Not that they are not going to have problems, though. They will have problems. But what the Lord is telling you and I today is that make sure that the environment where you are raising your sons is an environment where there is no jealousy, there is no anger, there is no bitterness, there is no comparison, there is no one-sided love. It will help your sons to care for themselves. So that when the other one needs help, he does not even think it too much. There is no pride to say, hold on, please, I need to call my brother. How would you feel that your son picks up his phone and calls one of his brothers and say, please, can you lift me up in prayer, guy? I need this in, God, I'm going for this contract. Please, lift me up in prayer. And you just see your children pouring out love, pouring out blessing, pouring out joy, pouring out peace, pouring out grace, speaking words of affirmation, speaking words of grace, speaking fires of God upon their brothers. How would you feel as a parent when you look at the generation you are raising and you see that that is the generation God has called upon you? God has not just called us to raise sons. He has called us as parents to raise brothers. Look at the story of the prodigal son and his brother. When the prodigal son returned, that is the kind of father or the kind of parent I would want everybody. The first son got angry and said, I've been taking care of this. I've been doing this. You have never celebrated me. You have not done this to me. Now he has returned. You are making this. You are building this. You are calling gongo. You are calling talking drum. What did the father say to him? Whatever I have is your own. You are in charge. But that this one was lost. Now he has returned. Please don't mind all this, my musketeers that are making noise. They are watching PJ Masks. So what am I saying? The prodigal son's father made the elder son to realize that this your brother was lost. Don't worry, everything is your own. You are the one that everything is yours. You are here. I have raised you. So we have to welcome him so that we will nurture him back to the legacy we want to grow him into. Not, come on, shut up. What do you mean? Is it your money? Am I not the one that made the money? Some parents would have made mistakes. Me, I might have shouted like that too. I don't know. But I picked a message from the prodigal son's father. How he encouraged his first son to see that there is no one-sided love. There is no partiality. So what am I saying? Let us raise sons of grace that will become brothers of encouragement, that will become brothers of unity, that will become brothers of peace, that will become brothers of honor, that will become brothers of love, that will become brothers in decision, that will become brothers in, you know, pushing each other. This is what I have come to share with you today. So please encourage your sons, even if it's not in blessing themselves like my children, like my sons do. But you can encourage them to spend time with each other. They should learn to be in each other's company. They should learn, you know, to discuss together. Even if the elder one is so big and the small one is too chen, try to create a time where it is just their own time, where you don't put your mouth. Where you, sometimes I see my son, like, I'm like, what are you saying? What are you saying? He says, it's none of your business. I love that joy and I pray that they continue to grow in that. This will enable us to put fire of love, fires of grace and love of God upon them. So like I am saying to you today, we are not raising sons. We are raising sons that will become brothers of love till the end of time. So tonight, come your way next time. Go on and raise those worthy sons and brothers. May God encourage us to do more in Jesus' name. Amen.